what you got? Halloween, Bradley. Halloween? Sure, there's everything that's all right back in your old country. What are you talking about? All Fool's Day, Guy Fawkes Day. Sure, you were a kid once.
That's right. Sure, lad, forget something.
Sometimes, I think we have better times than the kids have nowadays. We had the woods to tramp in, the fields to play in, and decent homes to live in. Look at these rat traps they call shelters. Oh, there comes the brains of the police department.
What's up, Peg? In the murder apartment fire. Stand by. Don't let anyone get away.
I know if it's too quiet to last. I'll cover the rear.
You live here?
Yeah. Apartment fire.
Apartment fire? What do you know about a murder?
A murder? That's me. Albert's murder.
Talking. Yeah, another false alarm. Why don't you put down your checkerboards and do something about it?
What do you mean, do something? We've got the homicide squad, the traffic department, and the sheriff's office tracing the call.
Yeah, it's pretty hot. They ought to turn the hose down here.
I wonder who could have did that. What's the matter with you?
Nothing. Just a little bit of nervous, that's all.
After on phone stations, have you? Looking for real trouble, eh? Come on, you've had enough fun for one night.
Where are you taking
it? What do you suppose?
What are we doing?
You should ask that with a telephone book in your hand. Get gone before you have the boys dragging the river for an automobile.
Say, when my old man hears about this, you're going to be minus a badge.
You've said enough for one night.
Why don't you put handcuffs on it?
You don't need handcuffs. All you'll need is something to button up that big mouth of yours.
Come along, gentlemen. The carriage is waiting.
Get me a cup of coffee. Man's got to have something to occupy his mind.
day.
That should worry you. You've wasted 365 whole days every year ever since I knew you.
Mary, I didn't want to worry you. But I had a feeling that maybe I ought to be going and seeing what's happened to Chuck.
Since when did you start worrying over Chuck? He's his father's son, can do no wrong, can he?
Well, I'd admit he's a fine, high-spirited lad, but a bit reckless. I was going to find Rook and ask him to keep an eye on him.
Rook never has his eye off.
Where have you been all day?
In the camp.
Well, ain't that nice?
Have you been thieving?
No, I ain't been thieving.
Then what did they put you into the can for?
All was Halloween, we pulled a couple of gangs and the cops got sore. You know that guy Lord's kid is too smart.
What did they do to you?
Nothing. They didn't give us a bag.
That's too bad. So what's your thing? Mm-hmm. Hard to tell you. He couldn't be the putting image of you.
Well, I was never in the can.
That's a pity. Don't dry your hands on the dish now.
It's good to eat.
Don't eat so fast.
Why are you picking on me?
Yeah, for a lot of reasons. One thing, you got your mother all upset. Spending the night in a can like a common hoodlum. Mm. How long is it since you quit school?
2 years.
You ought to be looking for a job.
A job?
I think it'd be a good idea.
Well, Pop, only fast work, you told me that yourself.
Yes, but,
Well, all right, am I like you or am I not? I've got my own gang, make them stand around just like you make everybody stand around in the district.
Yeah.
Do you work? Does Oldham work? No. Use your brain.
Sure, you get something.
Look where you are now. Maybe you'll be Oldham's boss. Get to be supervisor. Maybe you get to be mayor. Who knows?
Well, now, there's a lot of truth in what you're saying. But if it's a fair fight, then I have nothing more to say.
What fight?
There's some fresh cakes for
you. I don't know why you did it.
And I suppose...
No, I don't want any more coffee.
Now, Mary, do I get my briefcase?
I ain't seen it.
I heard you. It was lovely.
Thank you.
Where's your mother? Where's my patient?
Not
this beautiful person.
You're worse than normal. There's more sugar in your speech than there is in the medicine you gave me.
How do you feel?
I feel fine, Doctor. Honestly, it sure sounds foolish for me to be going away.
No, I think it's for the best. We'll have no more arguments. Oh, Nora, is this fresh water?
May I come in and look at your apartment? I'm the new owner.
You're not going to raise the rent, are you?
Of course not.
There you are, dear. You run and get your mother ready. The ambulance will be here in a second. Will you excuse her, please? Your mother's very ill. We're sending her away. I'd like to talk to you. Will you wait, please?
Yes.
Thank you.
Ambulance.
The poor little darling, they're taking her mother away.
Who's mother?
Nora.
The doctor told me
they might
take her away today. Did I understand you to say that you own this property?
Yes.
I've always wanted to meet the kind of person who owned a tenement like this, who lived on the poverty and misery of the people of the slums.
I beg your pardon.
Miss Fifth Avenue. Or is it Miss Riverside Drive, bleeding to death the poor devils who live here?
How dare you?
How dare I? I have to look after these people, to try and save their wretched and miserable lives. This lady here, I'm sending her away so she may have a chance to live. I don't always get them in time. Last week there was one downstairs. It was too late.
What?
They paid $12 a month, you know. The price of two orchids. But this filthy hole has given her tuberculosis. Just the same as every apartment you own that provides you income is breeding disease in the family of every poor devil who has to live here. I hope you enjoy the $12 a month. Bring that in here, please.
No. Don't let him see it, so that's the end of this coat.
chin up, baby.
Be a good soldier. That's it. I'll be back and see you in a little while.
Hey, come on now. Remember what the doctor said. You gotta keep your chin up.
Go on, go in the house. Go on.
Doctor, look at it.
Come on, I'll
take you. Hey, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Listen, Chuck. If I catch you fighting again, I'm going to run you in.
Oh,
what do you got there?
Nothing.
You'd better go over and see the doc.
Oh, I don't need to see no doctor.
Mind what I'm telling you. Go on over and see the doctor.
One of those.
I'll make a deal with you. I'll continue to patch up their bodies. You see what you can do for them, Leslie. Pardon me?
Now, Mary, do I get my briefcase?
You ask Jim Farley where it is. He got you home last night.
Oh, so that's it. I ain't even seen that low-down, backbiting, double-crossing piece of armor, let alone speak to him.
Then you wasn't out with him last night.
Never fear. I was with a Cy Alden, the boss of the district, discussing a big game that will end our worries for the rest of our day, if I put it over.
Oh, you found somebody to finance the burn tunnel under this landing.
Now, Mary, I've been trying to tell you about it all morning. Now, this is something more in my line as an organizer. I'm forming a union of the soda types that will give me an income of $1,000 a week.
You expect me to look forward to that?
Come in.
Well, how are you all this bright and shiny morning? I just come by to return your briefcase to you.
There's a briefcase, Baron. What to tell you?
Sure, I took the liberty of keeping it because it contains the papers from the organization of the big new soda test union.
Yes, I was just asking about it. Should have put up a chair and have a bite to eat.
No, thanks, Farhorn. I've had me breakfast, but I would have a small cup of coffee.
Yeah, heat up the coffee for him.
Hot now.
And then bring him a cup so that he can drink it. Are you sure you're not hungry?
No, I tell the truth, I'm not hungry.
Where were you when the fight started?
I was busy.
Why didn't you get in it?
I just don't like to fight.
Well, how are you going to get anywhere if you don't learn to fight?
I just do not get anywhere if I have to fight.
Well, look at Langford and Johnson. Look at Lewis.
Most of them were born big. I was born little.
Well, you better get in there. You're not going to be in the club.
How is your head this morning?
Terrible.
Oh, now, Mary, really, I've had a sufficiency. Of course, I don't want to offend you.
Tell Mary about our plans for organizing the soda truck.
Our plans? Oh, Foggy, you're the modest one. I only wish they were my plans. Mary, there's a fortune in it.
I was figuring out yesterday that the average week will net us $1,000.
That is a reasonable approximation.
What do you give the men for their money?
The right to bargain.
Right to bargain what?
Nora! Well, Nora, my darling. Now, ain't it fine that your mommy can have fresh eggs and milk and fresh air every day, huh?
Well, that's right. They took her to the sanitarium today, didn't they?
Well, I never had no faith in sanitariums.
Ah, you better be using your mouth eating other people's vitamins.
Aha,
been fighting
in the streets again, huh? Is your head all right,
Chuck?
Yes.
What happened to your head? Oh, Tony cracked me with a bottle when I wasn't looking. Don't ever let me hear of you fighting with bottles.
I don't need to fight with bottles. I can lick that mob with one hand.
All right. But don't forget what I've always taught you.
And don't forget your father was a three-time champion.
Yeah, I know.
Hey, Ma, what happened to my breakfast? That's your father's bosom companion here.
Get up and
let's
make a place for Nora.
Oh, no, I have some things in
the apartment. No, here. There's a letter sent here.
Say, why don't you live here all the time?
Ah, why not? Oh, no, I couldn't do that. Like, you couldn't afford it.
Who couldn't? I'm on the verge of a deal that will make us all practically millionaires. So don't you be worrying about where the money is coming from.
I want to stay awake waiting for us. We'll be getting along some way, darling.
You better take the chance while you have it, otherwise it'll be shoving you into an orphanage asylum. And believe me, they make you told them out there. You'll be up at 6 o'clock every morning, working hands all day, and this whole thing is not fit to throw out the window.
No, oh, no!
Kids, you keep your mouth shut. Didn't you have a hard enough time as it is now? No, you got to open that big, big mouth of yours. I don't know what you had this dude hanging around here for anyway.
That boy would mind. He wouldn't be permitted to talk to his elders in that fashion.
It ain't yours.
Don't forget that.
Mary, could I have another cup of coffee, please?
Hey, come on, cut that out. Come on.
I
ain't gonna take you no place. Don't pay any attention to that flannel mouth, Farley.
I don't wanna leave.
Well, you're not gonna leave, Tina. Stop your blubbering, will you? Can't think. Say, they can't take you away if you're working.
But I do work. I help everybody around here.
No, I mean you gotta have a steady job. You're gonna sing. That's it. You're gonna sing for Pete.
But they won't allow me. I'm not of age.
Now listen, don't think so much. You let me do the talking and you sing. But don't sing those old-fashioned songs. Gotta sing something new now. Torch songs, that's it, you know. Torch songs? You got a dime?
Mm-hmm.
Come on, I'll buy you a song. What's the matter?
I'm scared.
What you gotta be scared about? You got nothing to lose. Come on.
I'm my heart is answered for telephone that rings, but who's to answer? Or how the ghost of your face is fully remind me of you.
Fixed you up in this dinner. What's the matter, Roy?
You don't know what's the matter. This girl said she was 18.
You're lying, Pete. If you ever try to pull this again, I'll shut up this joint so tight you won't be able to get in or out. I assure you, ladies, that she has very fine parents. They take excellent care of her.
Well, I'd like to see her parents.
Why, certainly, lady. Come right along.
How about the dress? I see that you did it back.
See, Mom, I'm in the gym.
How are you doing?
I got no job done at Pete's Grotto. And two police things came in to pick her up. You gotta help me.
Oh, there's nothing in the sort. What? You're going to get out of your own jam.
But, Mom, it's not for me. It's on the kind of Nora. We got it all set with work to say that you're her mother.
Me lie?
Nora, don't you be frightened. Just leave it all.
Vernon, you'll have to talk to this daughter of yours. I picked her up singing in a cafe, pretending she was 18 years old.
Nora!
Why, sis.
Did you send that girl out to work? I did not, and I don't thank you for accusing me.
Yeah, I'm the man of the house here. You'll do your talking to me.
I'll send an investigator down here first thing in the morning to talk to you.
And I'll do all in my power to assist you, ma'am.
Hello, Nora, darling.
And what do you hear from your mother?
She just turned 20. You should have heard what Ma was telling. Said good night, ladies.
Good night. What are you trying to do?
Spoil everything?
Those were policewomen.
Just trying to convince them that Ma's Nora's mother.
Oh, my fine brother. Friend, you got us in a fine mess, didn't you?
Yeah, well, I took your tip and got you out of it, too.
We're not out of it yet. It's not so on busybodies as running to any other officer but me. This poor girl would be down in the juvenile home right now.
That's a good place for a few meals a day and a good education.
Stop your gab, Polly.
Well, I'll drop around in the morning and see what I can do. Good night to you all.
Good night, Uncle.
Good night.
Poor little thing. And whatever have I been putting on you? I suppose this is your idea, too. You're good for nothing.
Who put that into your head? I suppose you think that's using your brain.
No. Go away off, will you?
Why would my night break in the phone this morning?
But I'm just taping into your head that he is yours.
Well, I want no pardon.
Well, he's mine. You need
to go. Let's say he gave a tape again.
All right.
Good for you. I have some bad news for you, too. Kind of told me a while back. We're going to replace all the soda clerks with machines to mix all the drinks.
Oh. That's bad.
We'll organize the men that make the machines.
Are you? Is that brain of yours?
Nothing can stop you.
Oh, that's pretty. 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 Oh, that's pretty
Remember, we're partners.
Hello, Doc.
Hello, Rourke.
Oh, Miss Stone, this is Officer Rourke. He's on the night beat here.
How do you do, Miss Stone? I've heard a lot about you from the Doc. You've been telling me what you're going to do in the tournament. You sure need it. How's Nora?
I haven't seen her yet.
Anything wrong?
Two women were here from the Children's Aid Society. They're going to take her away.
Can they do that?
I'm afraid so.
This is something I can do. You know, the one in the thousand. I'll go with you.
Miss Stone, your new landlady.
Yes, I know. How do you do?
Mrs. Brennan, we want to see Nora.
Now, you're not going to take that child away. I'll get the papers, and I'm going to be your guardian myself.
I thought of something better than that. I'd like to send it to private school.
Would you? Oh, Nora, come out. It's all right. And wait till you hear this done.
Trying to frighten. Look, Nora, when I was a little girl, I went to a very nice school. I'd like to send you there. You'd have a lovely room all to yourself, or if you like company, you can live with another girl. You can have singing lessons, and dancing lessons, or anything you'd like to learn. Would you like to go there?
Oh, don't I'd love it, but I couldn't let you do it.
What's the matter with this place? She don't need singing lessons. She needs singing lessons, I'll get her a teacher.
Quiet, you.
I think that's for Nora to decide. I'm sure you'd be happy there, dear. And then when your mother's well, you two can be together again.
Nora, aren't you the lucky one? I think heaven must have sent Miss Stone down here to us.
Ah, bless her. Would you like to go now?
Oh, yes.
Well, I'll get you things. My car's outside.
You're going away.
Come here to me. I don't suppose you'll talk to us when you get back. So where's that set? I sent in my report to the department. It'll be okay with the juvenile authorities and everybody will be satisfied.
What's there to be satisfied about, huh? You sure messed things up good, didn't you, Carter? It'll be enough out of you.
Yeah, ain't you the hero, huh? Take a girl away from the place where she's born and raised and knows everybody and turn her over to a woman who sends her to some school where she don't know anybody at all.
Chuck, don't be disrespectful.
Well, how are you going to have any respect for a woman who's so dumb she buys people lambs and rugs and bathtubs that they don't even want?
They'll hop the lambs and put garbage in the bath.
I'll keep that in mind.
Yeah, you keep something in mind. I thought you were dumb, but she's dumb.
Quiet, little lad. Don't worry about it, Mrs. Brennan. She's only suffering from growing pains.
Avenue. I think you're swell.
Same school the lady went on to the apartment. I fixed that.
Oh.
don't pick me. My old man's a thief. What I lose him. He's a thief. I'm scared.
Oh, you're yellow.
Your old man's a crook, and you're a crook too.
He was born in here. You can't get away from it.
Oh, let him alone, fellas. Go on, Spike. You better go. You're too little.
Must I go?
You heard what I said, Spike. Now go on, beat it.
I'll give you up, though.
Yeah, yeah, okay, Spike. But go on, we're busy now. Blow. Pull the door out.
How do we get you rats out? With cheese?
Say, Luigi wrote that. He's the only one who could spell that good.
They're asking for it.
Go see where they are.
Guys, you can bring 10.
Okay, Chuck.
Give me that.
Well, boys, you know what to do. They accept the challenge. Wipe the place up with them.
Chuck's waiting for you. There's 7 of us. But you can bring 10. You'll need them.
Yeah, we'll bring 7.
Okay.
Well, I told the guys and they said they'd only bring 7.
Ah, make it an easy on us, eh?
Get set, fella.
We had enough nerve to walk in, did you?
You walked in, but you're gonna be carried out.
That's so?
Yeah.
I'm gonna give you a chance to part my hair with a bottle this time.
Who did?
You did, you think?
You're nothing but a two-bit guy.
You're the kind of a guy that steals to the coppers, and if you can't find the copper, you steal to another guy.
Yeah? Well, I don't try to make money off a girl that sings.
Oh, you're the guy that steals to them women reformers, huh?
Thank you.
I said Spike was yelling.
Why do you talk too much?
Remember all the rubdowns you gave us on this table?
Oh, shut up, will you?
Flowers. We gotta get some flowers.
Where'll we get them?
Well, where do we always get them? Go on, go get some flowers. Hurry up.
Is Nora gonna stay?
I don't know. I told the doctor to get her.
You think she'll come?
How do I know?
Maria. For the little colored boy. Hey, poor little bambino. There. Put them in the sidewalk.
Yeah.
So the boy can hear them. You see, Maria? Now they are happy.
For to carry him home, sweet chariot, coming for to carry him home. I long for the garden, and what did I see? Coming for to carry him home. Coming after you, coming for to carry you home. Ring low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry you home.
Our Father, art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven.
Put that chair down. Just been painting. What a change it's made of you to have everything nice and clean.
You don't want anything. Haven't been to you, the colored boy would be alive today. Wasn't your fight even been in the way of the truck? You're the one that's responsible for his death. He was one of your boys, wasn't he? Boys that you're teaching to lie and to steal the fight. That was a good boy. Laid down his life for a friend. The finest thing a man could do. You wouldn't understand. If you keep on, you'll be taking lives. And if you don't go to work,
What do you do to join up?
Want to join the Navy and see the world?
No. I just want to get out of town.
What's your name?
Chuck Brennan.
How old are you?
16, almost 17.
You're almost too young to join the Navy. When's your birthday?
10th of November.
I'm afraid you'll have to come back then.
What do you mean?
We can't take enlistments under 17.
How do you like that? Tell a guy the truth and he turns you down. I could have just as well said I was 17. You wouldn't have known the difference.
Oh, I think we could have found out. If you really want to be a Navy man, though, come back on your birthday and bring your parents' consent. I'm sorry.
Been around. Come on, let's go shoot some cool. Set him up, huh, Pop?
This is good, yeah.
You know who that is? That's Blackie Davis. I seen his picture in the paper. You know, Big Danny.
This is terrible. You need some more paper, Joey. Some more bright lights. Stick some slot machines over there. A nice little cocktail bar right over there.
That's swell. Give it to him a little class.
That ought to do it.
Play a little pool, Jen?
Blackie Davis.
Oh. Yeah, I'll take it over this part of the town.
You've got a partner, fella.
Partner? I don't need a partner.
You heard what he said. You got a partner.
I've run this place successfully for 20 years, and I'm not interested.
And you're still gonna run. If you're a nice boy.
Be smart, McCarthy. Make yourself some dough.
What's your name, kid?
Chuck Brennan.
Right, boy, you keep your ears wide open, don't you?
I just heard you say you're taking over this part of town.
That's right.
You know, you want to talk to me. If there's anything worth knowing around here, I know it.
That's well. So you say you and I take a little walk and you show me around?
Sure thing.
Okay, Polly. Some people, they make too much dough. You forget to pay off. That's
That's where we come in. We go out to collect.
Oh, collect?
That's right.
Sure.
I'll tell you more about it later. Here, go and get yourself some clothes.
Gee, thanks. Thanks a lot.
That's all right. Wait a minute. How about the loose lip? Buttoned up. What about that acne crowd? They won't pay off.
I had to kick the manager's door 3 times today.
You should have to take care of them yourself. What do you want to know?
Am I in on it, sir?
By that, aren't you?
Sure.
Okay. Good night. Who brought me?
Blackie Davis. He had a 38 automatic.
Where did he hang out?
In the apartment.
Blackie Davis. They had the apartment. Pick him up.
Come on, boy.
They're yellow, right? They don't fight still. They use guns. Yep. They use you for a stooge.
Mm. I call my own. Wrong in his life. Maybe he never would, but he was always on a square.
Why did you run to me?
saw you were down, they kept shooting at you. That isn't what we fought, is it? We always gave you a chance.
Yes, sir. We always did.
Slick, isn't it?
How long do you think you'll be gone?
Oh, I don't know, 4 years maybe.
Chuck, I'm gonna miss you,
Mom. I miss you too, Nora.
Texas on float 5.
Well, I guess that's me.
Well, goodbye.
Goodbye. Well, I gotta be gone.
Yeah, I guess you do. You won't forget me, will you, Chuck?
No.
Texas on float 5.
Oh, I guess that's me.